difference between voices and instruments, it depends on the music you are doing. You see, in Baroque music, there is not so much difference between voice and instruments on the whole 18th century. But if you are working with voices alone, with a cappella music, so yeah, you should know as a conductor something about that singing technique or how to build a sound. For my vision is that if people know the common vowel of the music they are singing, so they are able to bring a common sound. So of course this works best in their native language, but of course if you do other languages, Italian or Latin or English, you should know exactly the color of the vowels. This is the secret of what I'm doing with a cappella music, because we did today Peace on Earth by Schoenberg, and this works only like this. These tremendous harmonical problems, they work only if people have the same understanding of singing and of vowel colors, and then they are able to have a good intonation, which is the most important problem, and is the difference between instruments and voices, because instruments, of course, they have to find their intonation also, but they have a violin has a help as a player of wind instruments has an instrument, but a voice has no instrument, and the voice has to be built by itself, and so these are the problems or the differences between instruments and voices. You fight for the best results wherever you are. If you are in Vicenza or in Bolzano or in Stuttgart or in Berlin or wherever you are, the most important thing is that you do always the same, have always the same serious attitude to this fantastic music. Maybe another secret is that I love this music I'm doing. If I would not love this music, I would not have no chance to have any success or to bring music to life.
Thank you.
We are doing, let's say, 10 projects a year, and for me this is perfect because then I'm able to work with other ensembles also as a guest conductor with other orchestras also, and I would not be able to work with the same ensemble every week, to start every day rehearsal 10 o'clock would be not possible for me, because the most important thing also besides enthusiasm is that you forget routine. So I like to have a mixture of every style and every ensemble, not only choir, not only orchestra alone, not only oratorio. Also in July we do a scenic performance of Orfeo by Gluck and so on. So this mixture, this changing of styles and of ensembles, this is my most interesting thing I want to keep. Of course, I'm teaching, but not so much. I'm not teaching regularly. I do master classes, and that means, let's say, two or three times a year, and that's good. That's enough.